You want to know who we are?
We are gentlemen of Japan.
Many of us in John. Many a screen and fan. We figure in lively pain. Our actions queer and quaint.
You're wrong, you think it ain't.
Hey, come on, embrace living in the country, driving on the open road, singing Gilbert and Sullivan. What's more American than that?
First of all, Gilbert and Sullivan were English.
I knew that.
You knew that.
Want me to put on something else?
No, not in your life.
Isn't it cool? We're actually using four-wheel drive. But we're the only one of our friends that can say that.
David, I'm wondering how the trucks made it back here.
I'm sure they did.
Yeah, I gave them directions. But I also said we'd be there to supervise. I know we were going to be stopping for strawberries.
I wanted to stop.
Peas.
I've never done the old roadside stand
thing. Spinach.
Thought it was important for Lucas.
And asparagus.
He should know where food comes from.
David, food comes from farms, not stands.
They both are farmers.
I think I see a light.
Where are we?
Hey, we're home, Peanut.
It's really dark. Where are all the apartment buildings?
They don't have apartments in the country, baby.
Babe, Dana, it's a good move. Believe me?
Yeah, I believe you.
New beginning.
New beginning.
Kidding me? I thought they were supposed to put everything inside the right rooms.
Well, obviously they didn't.
Hey, Peanut. I just want to find a bathroom. I have to go in at once.
Hunter, your heels.
Here I come, here I come.
Please be careful. Mirrors like this here.
Oh, you guys got a hot wife and wants as many of her as possible.
Daddy!
Kitchen has potential, huh?
Yes.
Is there any coffee going?
Oh, if you want coffee, you're gonna have to find the coffee maker first.
Found her.
Fuck you.
Oh, is that a threat or a promise?
It could be a promising threat.
Or a threatening promise. Where's the peanut?
He's upstairs, waiting for his waffles. Oh, and we have a leak in the breakfast room. Talking to? Baby, I asked you a question. Who were you talking to just now? Lucas, turn around. Oh, no. Lucas, where'd you even find that thing?
He lives here. This is his home.
Oh, well, I'm sure he'll be even happier when we take him outside.
He said he'll protect me.
Baby, I'm sure he did. We've talked about this before. Okay, no pets.
Please, Mommy.
Hey, where'd that come from? Hey.
Let me have a go at that.
Hey, you stink, little guy. Guess what? I just saw a mouse downstairs, and it was huge, and he had his nose in the waffle cupboard. So I guess we could use a good mouser, babe.
Yeah. He's a really good mouser.
Hey, hold still, you little rascal. Hey, how about Rascal? Rascal's a good name.
Yeah, I think it's a cool name.
Nope. Ooh.
Dana, did you say we drive into town, get some groceries, lay of the land?
David, there's something out here.
We live in a country now, babe. What kinds of crazy critters out there?
Like what?
Maybe it's a raccoon. An occasional zombie redneck. Hey, Dana, come on. I'm sure the locals are eager to sneak a peek of the new lord and lady of the manor. One peanut, but what they do have is a sixplex up the road
afternoon.
In Newburn. Oh, afternoon. You see that? Friendly. Look at that. It's a genuine barbershop. Huh? Ah, friendly neighborhood gun store.
Hey.
Hey, we'll go wild turkey shooting. How about
Did
that?
Did you forget? I'm a vegetarian. I do not like killing animals.
You don't?
That's okay. We shoot watermelons instead.
Hey, I've heard about this place. Oh. Yelp says that this place is the best ice cream this side of the Mississippi.
No way!
Yeah,
really?
Better than the ice cream factory in Brooklyn.
Afternoon.
Hello.
Hey.
I bet I know who you all are.
Oh, I bet you do.
You all bought the Blacker House.
Oh, yeah, that's us.
Oh, welcome! Welcome, welcome! Oh, I'm so happy to see some new faces around here.
Well, happy to be a new face. Hey, I'm David.
David?
This is my wife, Dana.
Hi.
Are you?
And this little sugar addict over here is our son, Lucas. Hey, get up.
Marty Morrison, and the pleasure is all mine. And hi, Lucas.
Hi.
What's your favorite ice cream?
Strawberry.
You are so in luck. I just made some strawberry this morning. Is that okay?
Yeah, sure. It's fine.
All right, let's get scooping. You know, nobody has lived in that old house for quite some time. I'm afraid that you all have your work cut out for you.
Yep, got a leaky roof for starters.
Oh, now listen, if you need some help with the big stuff. I mean, I'm happy to recommend some honest, hardworking people.
You know, actually, we're
Ben Phillips Jr. Now, that's not to be confused with Ben Phillips Sr., who drinks, enough said. But Ben Jr. now, he knows his way around a hammer, and he is not bad to look at. I said that out loud, didn't I? That's awful. Oh, get behind me, Satan. That's terrible.
You know, actually, we were hoping to do most of the work ourselves.
Oh, is that right? What, are you some kind of architect or?
Well, funnily enough.
Look at you. Oh, I guess that you're a man who knows the way around a hammer, too.
I do. I'm actually the architect. I'm going to be doing most of the work on the house.
Is that right?
Yeah, that's right.
It's a big job.
Big job.
And what is it that you do?
In between my naps? I enjoy watching her work, playing Xbox.
Oh, uh-huh.
We actually just came in to say howdy, pick up a few things for the house.
Well, howdy. And just look around, let me know if you can't find something. And good luck with your house.
Lucas? Lucas? Lucas, what is it?
There's a dog out there.
It's probably just a stray.
I'm scared.
Oh, it's all right, Peanut. We'll protect you. Mommy will protect you.
Mommy?
Mommy. Oh my God. Lucas.
No!
Lucas. David. One of my dreams.
Dana, are you okay?
Yeah, David, I'm up here. I need your help.
Where's the lion and the witch?
Well, technically it's called a chifferobe.
Yeah, chifferobe, huh? What's it made of, lead? Positive you saw our light up in here?
Yes, and then it went off.
Yes, what you're doing outside in the middle of the night, young lady?
I was getting some air.
Yeah, it's probably just a faulty wire or something.
Well, all the more reason to check it out. Oh, wow.
Cool. Our own secret room.
Oh, of course.
What?
Yeah, we're stuck.
See anything?
No, it's too dark.
Hey, Dana, come on up. Find a locksmith in the morning to get it open. Hey, Dana, come on. Dana, it's late. Stop.
What?
Hey, you okay?
Yeah.
You got that look that concerns me. Want me to call Dr. Ashby in the morning?
No.
Sorry.
No, I'm getting adjusted. That room's not on the floor plan, please. Bugging me a little bit. Thank you.
David? Lucas, is that you? Lucas?
He doesn't want you.
Gentleman is my wife. Mad, and the offspring of a mad family.
Round. Get it back round. Reverse. Reverse. That's right. Move it back. Move it back. Backroom. 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 Hey, Baba. Where'd you come from?
Where were you? I needed you, David.
Babe, I'm right here. I've been right here.
I was locked up. Locked up there for hours and hours.
Dana, I don't...
You didn't notice I was missing?
Dana, I swear to God.
I was upstairs, David.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
I was upstairs, David. I was locked in that little room in the attic.
Hey, wait. You got in?
Yeah, I found the key, and I went inside, and
Dana.
Then somebody closed the door. Somebody locked me in.
And nobody would do that.
Who was it, David?
I don't know. There's no one else here.
I was screaming for help for hours.
Dana, we have been down here the whole time. And we did not hear a thing. Honest to God.
We didn't hear a thing, Mommy. We didn't.
You having trouble sleeping?
No, I know. I'm not having trouble sleeping. Please don't look at me like that.
Like what?
Don't Don't get sick again, Mommy.
I'm not getting sick, baby. I've never felt better in my life. Where's Daddy?
He had to make a phone call. To Japan.
Well, I was thinking, I could set up your house for you, if you want. I mean, you could help, if you want.
Okay.
Okay. You remember how this goes together?
No.
It's okay, it's complicated. As for the clients, if your mom remembers correctly. Okay, first things first, we start with the bass. You gonna do it by yourself? You gonna do it all by yourself. Very nice.
Oh.
How about
yeah.
That one? Good job. And
that big boy. Couple more pieces to go.
What do you think?
That one.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You got it?
Yep.
Okay. That. Got it? Yes.
You're good.
Lucas.
Yeah.
I just wanted to tell you. I just wanted to say I'm sorry.
That's okay. Sometimes bad things happen and you don't know why. I think sometimes maybe I'd like a sister again.
You would?
Hey, pick up the dough.
You don't speak baby?
Well, not anymore.
No? Baby selfie, baby selfie.
Think that child was begotten of my loins, rotten?
He won't let us out.
Not a chance in hell.
Mommy. Can I have my breakfast, Mommy?
Yes. Lucas, you can have your breakfast.
Sorry.
Oh, for God's sake.
I really am sorry, ma'am. I wouldn't scare you too bad. It was not my intention.
I'm sorry, who are you? What are you doing sneaking around on my property?
Answering your prayers.
See, it's gone unchecked for a while.
Lucky it didn't cave. Lucky I stopped by when I did.
Well, and lucky for you, people around here like to gossip.
Bet they do. Also heard you were an architect or something.
Yeah, or something.
Well, maybe we should talk about money.
Well, that's a little premature.
Come again?
You haven't been hired yet.
No?
No.
Look, there's nothing I can do to change your mind.
Hello?
David, this is my husband, David. David, this is Ben Phillips, Jr.
Yes, the legend. Hey, nice to meet you.
Likewise.
Mr. Phillips is here about the leak.
Right.
Ben works fine.
Great, Ben. When can you start?
No, that's still up in the air.
As soon as you pull the trigger.
We should probably get on to this right away, babe, don't you think?
David.
The next couple weeks are kind of busy, but I am free now.
What is this? This is water damage, right? So does this pour anything?
Look, we'll get a dehumidifier in here. We're going to actually save most of this wood. Just say the word.
Great. Well, I guess we want you to start as soon as possible.
All right.
No. What I would like is for Mr. Phillips to come back here when it hasn't been raining for a few days, and the two of us can get up on that roof and see what's what. That way, once the situation's been thoroughly and properly assessed, then we can talk about hours and materials and scope of work in a manner that's not been pulled directly out of our asses. And what I'd also like is to agree on a deadline, which, if not met, means revisiting the terms of our contract with a probability of penalties paid to us by you for each day of work exceeding the original agreement. If that all sounds acceptable, then I'd be happy to resume this conversation at a later date. But in the meantime, it was a pleasure meeting you, Mr. Phillips, and my husband, David, will show you out. David, if you wouldn't mind.
Ben. I'm sorry.
What are you sorry for?
I should have let you take the lead.
That's not a big deal.
Yes, it is. I was totally caveman about the whole thing. It was a full-on phallus fest. I mean, my God, what was I doing? I don't know anything about fixing a fucking roof.
I'm gonna leave this house. Something isn't right here.
Dana, whatever you're feeling or think you're experiencing, it's just you adjusting. It's not the house.
The Blackers had a daughter who died July 5th. That's the same day. The same day. That's not a coincidence. Their daughter is still in this house.
That's not possible. You know that. You still taking your medication?
Yes, I'm taking it. I don't want to stay here.
We agreed to give it a year of our time in this house. Dr. Ashby told us how important it was for Lucas to have stability right now. We bail in this house. We're not giving him a fair chance of a normal life. We owe him that. God knows we owe him that. In a year's time, we're going to look back at this and know that this move was the right thing to do. Believe me? I can cancel this trip in the city. It's just 2 days. Finalize the sale of the company, help with the transition. I can reschedule.
No, I don't want you to do that. Lucas and I can spend the time together. That'll be good for us.
I want you to keep an eye on your mother for me while I'm gone. Look after her. Want me to pick up some juniors for you while I'm gone?
With strawberries, no raspberries.
Yes, sir.
Oh, wow, look at that bear. Look, there's our house.
May I help you?
Yeah, I'm Dana Barrow, and I...
Dana the architect. It's nice to meet you, Dana. I'm the one who sent you the photographs and records of your house.
Oh, thank you.
And who might you be? Hey. What's the matter, cat? Got your tongue?
This is Lucas.
They call me Ms. Judith.
Say hi.
I'll just go put these away.
Okay. You can play over here. Let's just a minute. I wanted to ask you about this little room that I found in the attic. It's got a metal floor and a window that won't open and a door that just only locks from the outside. And it really frightens me, and it wasn't on any of the plans, and I don't know what to make of it. But it's ridiculous.
Maybe. Maybe not.
What do you mean?
Dana, it sounds like you have a disappointments room.
A what?
A disappointments room.
Well, what does that mean?
There was a time, not so long ago, when children who were born with certain difficulties were considered embarrassing. Especially if the family was well-to-do, prominent socially. Sometimes the decision would be made to keep that child's very existence a secret.
Go on.
So, confined to a room much like the one you described, tended to only by the parents or perhaps a trusted servant, that boy or girl would spend their lives, however long those might be, no one to talk to, no one to play with, never feeling the sun or the rain on their little faces. These children were
disappointments.
Their time on this earth was frequently brief, God willing. Then when it was over, they were buried discreetly. Some say their spirits could remain behind. So, I've been researching the presence of disturbed spirits in these old homes.
And?
And I think I've watched Poltergeist too many times. People say I'm full of shit and whiskey.
Hello?
Hello yourself.
What are you doing up there?
Thought you said to come back in a few days. So, what are you thinking?
I think all this needs to go. Say we demo the existing and build a new one. With pitch. Better drainage.
Standard per foot?
Quarter inch. First strips, plywood, new flashing, new tar paper.
Top of my head, I'd say it's a 4-day job.
Oh, I'd say a 2-day job, max.
Well, I bill $80 an hour.
Well, you'll get 60. So, 2 days, 60, 500 for materials, that's 1460 max.
You don't talk like an architect.
My father worked as a general contractor for over 40 years.
Is that right?
That's right. And he didn't like leaving me with babysitters, so I've spent a lot of time on site. And a lot of time around young men like you.
So then you used to see people smoking the job site. When did you start working for your daddy?
When I was old enough.
Doing what?
Whatever he'd let me do.
He must have been proud.
Of?
You getting a degree, becoming an architect?
Actually, he had a heart attack on the job a few months after I graduated.
So. Sorry to hear about that.
He died getting his hands dirty.
Just like you wanted?
I guess so.
So what about your mom?
Mommy!
Do not come up here, Lucas. Stay right where you are.
I'm hungry now.
I'll be right down. Just get off that ladder, please.
Where's his father?
He's in the city.
Coming home soon?
Yeah, in a few days.
Yeah. But it's scary at night, tucked up in bed all by yourself.
Congratulations. You just found the line.
Oh, yeah? So now what?
Now you can back the fuck up. You can start in the morning. I'll expect you around 8.
This is the garden of make-believe, a magical garden of make-believe. Here in the garden, what we say and do, we'd like you to join us and do it too. Can you crow like a rooster? Cock-a-doodle-doo! And clap your hands and stamp your shoe. It's a funny place, but it's surely true that we'd like to share it all with you.
Rascal! 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 Where are you, Rascal?
kids right now, honey. Lucas?
Doesn't want you here.
Who?
Why don't you go look in those trees? He's a really good climber.
Okay. Rascal! Rascal! Where are you? Rascal! Rascal! Come down wherever you are. Come down, kitty kitty. Where are you?
You look over there. I think I heard him. He's not out here, baby. He's probably back in the house. Let's get you in the bow.
We'll find him?
Yeah.
Thank you. I feel like she's slipping. She had a few episodes, but she completely lost track of time. And she thinks that odd things are going on in the house.
Odd in what way?
She started to imagine things that aren't really happening again.
Catherine's birthday would have been Sunday, right?
Yeah.
We both know that you tend to bury your feelings for the greater good, and that is not good for you either. Being out in that big house, way outside of the city, is very isolating. Why don't you have people over on Sunday? She doesn't need advice. She needs friends.
Okay.
There's a gravestone out back. It's probably an old dog's, but it scares Lucas. Would you dig it up and make sure it's nothing? I don't want David to know.
Yeah, then I'll do that. Sure hope he appreciates all this. I said I sure hope he appreciates all this. I hope he appreciates all that you're doing for him.
Well, what am I doing?
Leaving the city, buying the old house in the country, fixing it up so you can throw some big dinners, everyone gathered around your beautiful stickly table, eating vegetables you grew out back or bought at the corner at the farmer's stand. Isn't that the plan?
Yeah, or something. How would your girlfriend feel about us sharing smoke?
I don't have one. If I did, I probably wouldn't care what she thought.
Why not?
I don't live my life worrying about things I can't control.
And how's that working out for you?
Works out just fine. Keep you working around here long enough, you might get to see or feel how it works out for yourself.
Well, it's a shame we're almost finished.
We don't have to be.
You weren't home till tomorrow.
I was. And then I thought I should be home with my wife and my son.
Hmm? How did you get home from the station?
Oh, I got a cab. You know, I think the driver doubles up as the town's dentist in his spare time.
Was it a productive trip?
Yeah. Yeah, I guess it was.
Was it productive?
Yes. It was productive. Those paintings are incredible, huh? Don't you think? I mean, I can't imagine, I can't fathom why, but someone want to cover them up.
I can't.
Are we taking our...
No. No, I'm not.
That's probably not the best idea.
No, it's probably not. But they make me feel...
fuzzy.
Fuzzy. I should get back to work. Lucas will be happy you're home.
that line, buddy. We just crossed into North Carolina. We should be there around 5.
Yeah, great.
So where exactly is Dana?
Maybe we should start cleaning up.
She's here. Jesus H.
No, please, sit. Sit! I'm really sorry I'm late. Please forgive me. It took me forever to find what I was looking for. But I guess that's life in a small town. A very, very, very small town. As far away from civilization as David could manage. Right, David? No big city conveniences for us. Just peace and quiet. How are the game hands?
Tasty.
That's good to hear. Because so often when David tries to take care of something, he just fucks it right up.
Dana, you're being rude.
Hey, I was trying to be funny. But I forgot. David is the funny one. Which makes me the not funny one. David's the funny one. David has a job. I am on a leave of absence from the firm I founded. David makes game hens. I can easily fuck up a waffle. David is a loving and wonderful parent.
Dana is drunk.
David is not drunk!
How are you doing, Dana?
Well, I don't know how I'm doing, Jules. How am I doing, David? I think my husband would say I'm not 100%. Maybe 98. You know, I have my ups and my downs, my good days and my bad. But what's great is I have a purpose. Fixing this house is gonna make it all better. Right, David?
You know, they say that moving can be very stressful, like divorce or a death.
Is that what they say?
I read that somewhere.
Maybe you could give us a seminar on the 5 stages of grief, since you've so obviously read a fucking pamphlet.
Dana!
Now who's being rude? It's not polite to interrupt someone when they're talking, David. In answer to your question, Jules, I would say this move has been a lot like a death. A lot. Which reminds me, excuse me for one moment. Maybe we should go.
Stay right where you are, Jules. Nobody's going anywhere before we have dessert.
David.
Oh, my God.
While they're saying happy birthday, she can't hear you. Or maybe she can. Who knows? Catherine, are you listening? Are you with us, baby?
All right, Dana, just stop it.
Stop what, David? Spit it out.
There's no excuse for this, Dana. No excuse.
Oh, come on. What's a birthday party without a birthday cake? Isn't that why they're here? Isn't that why you asked them to come all the way here on the one day out of all possible days that they could have come? So here we are, sitting at our table, eating our food on the exact day that I gave birth to our daughter 1 year ago.
Dana, please, I'm begging you, stop this.
You asked them to celebrate Catherine's birthday. And we're gonna celebrate Catherine's birthday.
No.
Sit down, David. Let me cut you a slice of cake.
I said no, Dana. I'm not
just gonna... let me cut the fucking
Dana,
cake!
Dana, stop! Dana,
let me cut!
Dana, stop! No! Dana, give it to me! Stop!
Fine!
Go!
Fine! Take it! Take that! It's 90 days. I guess that was old enough, you know? Was old enough to know she wanted no part of me. No part. So she just stopped. Breathing. I can't do it anymore, David. I'm sorry. That is all my fault. Oh, you poor thing. Out of here all by yourself. Lucas? Lucas?
We have allowed this curse to linger too long.
Don't I beg you!
Will embarrass me no more.
Out of your fucking mind? Fuck! Are you trying to destroy everything we ever had, Dana? Everything, are you?
Is he okay?
Yeah, he's fine, Dana. He's fine. He's asleep in our bed. He thinks it was a bad dream.
David, I think I can't tell anymore what's real and what's not real.
There was no one there. Nobody was trying to hurt Lucas, Dana. It was just... just you.
I almost killed him. I killed
that was an accident. That was a horrible accident. That's all it was. And you know that. We need to get back home. No more running. You will get better. There's nothing we can't overcome.